because there are a lot of options for me. Wait, wait for it. Yep. One down at least. Another one down. Alright guys, this is RB and welcome back to part 19 of my Watch Dogs playthrough series. So previously in the game, as you have seen that we were in Pawnee searching for the legendary CTOS hacker slash Blume cyber terrorist known as Raymond Kenny. We found the guy brooding in a bar, drunk and sober about his good old times. But when Aiden tried to talk with him, he kicked the shit out of him, stunned him using a stun gun. And when Aiden came to his consciousness, he debated a little bit, asked for his help, and Kenny, or T-Bone, whatever he likes himself to be called, agreed to help Aiden, but on a very small condition that he must also help him get out of Pawnee into Chicago, because Blume has a few countermeasures, I think, to keep him confined into Pawnee. Moreover, keep him inside Pawnee and make it kind of as his prison. So we are about to infiltrate the Blume HQ. I guess I'm not sure about what we are about to do, but as we enter the game, we'll know. So stick to the end of the video to find out what happens, whether we are able to hack into the Blume HQ or not, and whether we are able to free Kenny or T-Bone, whatever you like to call him, from the clutches of Blume. And if you do not understand what I'm speaking about and you do not know what is happened or has happened till now, then don't forget to check the previous video out for the sake of context. The link is already given in the description and even on the iCard right now for the sake of your convenience. After watching this video or the previous one, if you feel that any of them were worth your time or you enjoyed watching them, then don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel for more amazing gaming content and walkthroughs. Moreover, be a part of my journey in becoming the best gaming content creator ever present on YouTube. This is a small ambition of mine and it cannot be made successful without your support and your appreciation. So if you like the video, then don't forget to show it by clicking the thumbs up button. Alright? So with all that being said, let's not delay the video any longer and dive in straight into today's gameplay. And I hope you enjoy the video. Alright guys, welcome back to the walkthrough once again. We are in front of our hideout at Pawnee, or should I say the hideout of T-Back or T-Bone, whatever. So today the quest in our hand is called as A Pit of Paranoia. I think it is about us hacking into the Blume HQ, but I'm not very sure. I'm just speculating, alright. If by chance I get correct, then that's very nice of me. Okay, let's take the tow truck and just go on our way. Skip the song, yep. Try not to ram into anything.
Another unexplained blackout occurred today. Public officials are scrambling to find a cause for these strange power outages.
Okay, about the power outage, we heard in the previous video that T-Bone also caused sort of a power outage using the CTOS, and in that procedure 11 people got killed. Now, was that sort of planned, incidental, unincidental? I think we shall find out in the future. So till now I think T-Bone is not a very bad character, because after Aiden told him about the death of his niece in the previous video, the guy showed some sympathy to him. Honestly, the guy agreed to help him because of that reason. Okay, a pit of paranoia. There are a lot of people standing here, but why? Looks like a camping site. Yeah. All right, here we go.
So now I need security clearance for Blume HQ. Where I turn Blume's involved. These guys are up to something that's a lot more than CTOS. I hope T-Bone knows what he's doing. Okay, I'm in position. Now, what about these helicopters?
Wait for it. Go! Don't lose it!
Okay. Oh. How am I supposed to steal something like that, which is flying? Like, it's gonna be tough. It gives a very GTA kind of vibe, I'm gonna be honest. I think CTOS has a secret bunker sort of thing and the helicopter takes us close to it. I don't know. Just speculating. Alright. There is only one backdrop about these bikes.
Helps us because
it's a routine. Blume HQ changes security protocol every day. Blackbird makes a trip over Pawnee with the new assignments.
So basically, the chopper's gonna lead us to the security chief.
And Bingo was her name.
Okay. I'm following not the helicopter, but rather the map, the mini game map. I can see. Okay. Don't panic. Yep, do some off-road driving. There we go, nice. Follow the road. Okay, I'm gonna take the opposite side because I don't care. I'm as savage as it can get. Okay, it's going 162 meters in that direction, alright?
Hovering over a trailer park.
Well, that doesn't make any sense. Wait a minute, it makes perfect sense. A lot of the Pawnee militia run security for Blume. And a lot of them live in that pit of paranoia.
And one of them's the security chief.
With full access.
I can hardly wait.
You remember that bunch protecting the truck? Same gang. The Pawnee militia is made up of preppers. Survivalists, anti-government types, my kind of people. Which means they won't fuck around. Cold, dead hands, and all that crap.
Okay.
So one of you guys is the newly crowned security chief.
And I need to take the dude out. Okay. Avoid detection by profiling from sky. Okay. Now, that, should I say, is a concern. Okay. Let me use a camera, right? No. Okay, got another component. Okay, with explosives. One of those big dudes. Another one of those big dudes. What do I need to do? Hack the copper to find two security chiefs. Okay. Come on. Lock on this bastard.
That one has potential. Who else?
Okay. One is standing right there.
Give me some options.
Got another one. Let's see. No. That's a commoner. I think that's a commoner. No, not these. anyone whom I have not scanned. Okay. Sniper. Should be somebody around here, right? Let's look around. No. Okay. I can disrupt the comms. Of course I can do that, but I need to look for the security coordinators. This is also an explosive. Wait, there is a guy. Let me see where. There's another dude right there, if I'm not wrong. Wait. I think I saw another dude back there. Like, he's underneath this area. Not sure if I spotted something correctly, but I thought there was a dude right there, right here somewhere. No, nothing in here. Nothing in here. This guy must be somewhere a little bit remote. I'm sure about it. Come on, get in range. Okay, take down both Blume security chiefs.
Okay. This is more than just a gun club. You got control of half the park. Is this normal for Pawnee?
Ain't nothing normal in Pawnee. When Blume started dumping money into this place, things took a turn for the weird.
Okay, I need to take out both the security chiefs, right? So let me just look around what I can exactly do, because there are a lot of options for me. Wait for it. Yep. One down at least. Another one down. Okay. Come on. Okay. Few out, but not all of them. I still need to look out for a lot. Come on. Okay, another one down. Let us just keep waiting a little bit. Because I have a gut feeling that I will take out all of them using the traps. At least, if not all of them, a good chunk of them using most of the traps. Because the marksman is down, so I don't need to worry about the snipers. But still, the remaining enemies are all scattered around, and more or less all of them are somewhere or the other not close to these explosive traps. So now I'm thinking, what should I do? Should I just go in and go all guns blazing? Because if I do that, the chopper will spot me and I can't blow my cover, because if that happens, I don't think that would be a good option to do. Okay. Let's see. There must be an option, right? Wait. I have an idea. A small idea. It just might work out. Okay. I think there is a sniper. Okay. Let me wait for the chopper to go out. Come on.
Shit, you don't have it.
Okay.
Let's try another one.
One down, one more to go. Let us just be careful. Okay, down. Nice. Okay. Let me see. The camera is coming towards this direction. I hope it does not spot me. I think there are three guards. And one marksman, I guess. Oh, the marksman is not down yet. Okay, let me just distract them a little bit.
I got nothing. I'll check over there. Moving on.
Uh-oh. Okay, there you go.
Wait.
One more down. Oh, is it?
Wait.
Can you see me?
Look for him. Go over there.
No way he's gone.
Alright. I think only the marksman knows that I am here. If I am just a little bit careful, I should be good enough to take it out. Kill all militias or escape, okay? What the hell? Alright. I don't think there are any more militias, right? So, let me just get out as fast as I can, because I don't need to fight a helicopter. I got the code. That's fine enough. Is it a code or something else? Alright. Completed with 2000 XP. Nice.
We've got our access to Blume HQ now.
Damn. I'm sorry I doubted you.
Why would you doubt me?
I'm a realist. Listen, I'm coding a dirty little virus to erase me from their system. Damn, I'm good.
And then I waltz into Blume with my access and your code. What's security like?
Oh, good point. You might call it thick?
Yeah, well, let's thin their numbers then. You track any of their truck deliveries?
Of course I am.
Send me the routes and let me make some noise.
Okay, now we are intercepting their truck deliveries. Unstoppable force, alright. I think this is gonna be pure gunfight, that's it, nothing else. Probably it's gonna be pure gunfight because he is going to stop military convoys, right? So that should have a lot of firepower and action involved in the travel and stealth. Of course, there'll be times when I will get my chance to use the tips and tricks and my environment to take the enemies out, but apart from that, I think it will be something like those wave things where there's a first wave of enemies, there's a second wave, and you keep fighting them until they are over. Okay, that's very close to the hideout, honestly. Unstoppable force. Okay, in front of the pawn shop. Can I enter the pawn shop? Buy something, I guess. Maybe prep up a little bit.
How's it going?
Okay.
What can I get you?
Electronic parts. Yes, sir.
You won't find what I've got anywhere else.
Give me as many as you can. I don't care. Let's see. Let's take 12 of these. Let's take two of the chemical compounds. All right, you're good.
All right.
All righty. What's this? A toy? Okay. That's spooky. So there's a muscle car parked right here. I guess for the mission. Let's see. So here we go.
Militias made of security contractors. That means when they fuck up, they lose business. If I create some fuck ups, they'll send more men. That means less of them at Blume. Let's see this route T-Bone sent. And these guys are on a pretty direct path. Lots of opportunities for me.
Okay. We are searching out opportunities. That's nice. Let's see, what should I do? Let me take the muscle car. Just for the extra armor, right? Let me look where I need to go. Okay, this is our objective. Okay, need to turn left and keep moving. All right, I think I'll intercept them at some point. Uh-oh. What? Oh god. What the fuck? Did it seriously happen just like that?
T-bone sin. And these guys are on a pretty direct path. Lots of opportunities for me.
Okay. Take the muscle car once again. Mark your convoy. There we go. Okay. I'm sorry. Okay. These guys will come right in front of me. So, yep, they are coming. I'm sure they'll come.
What just happened?
Okay, neutralize them. At least paused their route for a sec, right? Now let me check how many cars actually come with it. 1, 2, 3. Okay, 3 cars. I can handle that. I need to just take them out on traffic lights and crossings. That's it. Uh-oh. Enemies are in pursuit, and you know that very well. There you go. Wham. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Oh, I whammed it into the first bastard, but I was unable to get all of them.
Let's see this route T-Bone sent. And these guys are on a pretty direct path. Lots of opportunities for me.
You know what? I have a very good idea. I'm gonna take them out and use a grenade launcher. That's it. Okay, lot of cars in this area. Come on. Okay. Sly bastard. But never mind. I can handle it. Are there not 3 cars with it? 1 in front and 2 behind it. I have the idea that I'm going to ram the car. Okay. Yep. That's the best you can do. Come on. There you go.
Drive into it. Do it.
Okay, get out. Get out. Get out. There you go.
Backup is here.
Let me see what backup arrives.
Stay alert.
Yep. Fuck your backup. Yep. That's your fucking backup. You moron. Okay. Now, I need to hide a little bit to replenish my health. Okay. Seriously? All right. Down. Any more left? I don't think so. Okay. Yep. There are a few left. Okay. Can be handled. Not a big deal. I took down all the fucking reinforcements. What do I even need to worry about, right? Okay, take the grenade launcher. You know what? Take something good. Alright. I think that's enough.
Ready for me?
More or less.
More or less?
More. It'll work, I think.
What does that mean? I'm walking into the lion's den.
Don't be dramatic. You reach their servers, this thing will work.
And you're the legend Clara's been raving about.
The what? Who?
Never mind.
Okay, we are about to enter a fucking Blume server. But I don't think I have enough ammo. Yep, I have completely famished the amount of ammo I had for my grenade launcher. Then let me just take a little bit of time out, collect a little bit of ammo, and then I'm going to go for it. All right, so let's do one thing, guys. Let's conclude the video for today right here at this point. And in the next video, we are going back to T-Dog and collecting the virus, after which the future is in Blume, which is also the objective we are about to clear out. So if you watched the video till this point and you felt it was worth your time or you enjoyed watching it, then don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel, as that really helps the video and the channel a lot, and it also helps a lot in fulfilling my ambition and dream to create the best gaming content channel ever present on YouTube, along with being the best gaming content creator. So if you want to support in that dream of mine and be a part of this channel, you're always welcome to do that, and any and every support you drop in the video really matters and counts, and I love you for doing that. If you did not like the video, then don't forget to drop the dislike and comment down where I can improve or upgrade the format of the gameplay so that you can enjoy it the next time you watch the walkthrough. So with all that being said, this is RB signing off for today. Peace. Until next time, I'll see you in the next part, which shall be part 20 of my Watch Dogs playthrough series. Till that time, stay tuned for it and stay safe. The RB signing out now.